Merry Christmas. My name is David Kenny, and I'm the pastor of Walden Community Church here in Montgomery, Texas. If you ever want to learn more about us, we're at facebook.com/Walden Church, instagram.com/Walden Church, and waldenchurch.com. We are here in the local community, and we want to be the church where you live. This Christmas, our theme is Peace Has Come. Not that peace is coming in the future or that one day peace will be here, but that peace arrived with the birth of Jesus. Now, every year we print off a little Christmas devotional. It's a reading that you can take with you, and it's got a little entry from December 1st all the way to December 25th, but I realized not everybody got one, and so I just said, you know what, I'm just going to read it and throw it up on YouTube for everyone to enjoy. Today's passage is called No Crib for a Bed. And there's a verse here from Luke chapter 2, and we're going to read verses 6 and 7. It says, "The time came for Mary to give birth, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn." If your family went on vacation, but when you arrived, all the hotels were full, where would you sleep? I think we all try to picture this scene. Mary is ready to give birth. Joseph is frantically knocking on the house after house after house, trying to find a place where she can deliver. And we all have memories of watching Christmas plays with a grumpy innkeeper who turns his no vacancy sign on and sends the couple away. That's probably not what happened. Joseph knew the census was coming, and he would have sent word ahead and made arrangements with family for a place to stay. Remember, this is Joseph's hometown. And if you read the passage, it just says the time came for Mary to give birth. It doesn't say that it happened the moment they pulled into town. It's more likely that they had already been in town for a few days or even weeks. The next detail simply says she gave birth in the animal stall because the upstairs guest room was occupied. The house where Mary and Joseph were staying was probably bursting with family members. And back then, poor families had an indoor room for their one or two animals. They didn't keep them outside in fear that they might be stolen. The lady of the house probably cleared a space for them in their animal room so that Mary and the other women could have some privacy. But the real truth is, it doesn't matter. The details of the story, however picturesque or graphic, don't matter. The only thing that matters is that Jesus was born. Holy Father, we know it was your plan to have the King of Kings born in a humble way. Thank you that Jesus came to serve the poor and the needy. Amen. Thanks for joining us today. Be sure to tune in tomorrow for our December 15th reading. Hey, and one more thing before you go. I want to take a moment to remind you about our Christmas Eve services. We actually have two opportunities for worship on December 24th. We'll have a service at 5 p.m. and a service at 7 p.m., both of which are completely identical. Pick the service that works the best for you and your family. Our church has really enjoyed serving you and worshiping alongside of you this year. We would love to be the church where you live. If you'd like to learn more about us, you can find us at waldenchurch.com. I love you guys, and I'll see you soon. Bye.